Leading our news this evening is a continuing drama over the man named Maurice Ainsworth, a Santa Cruz County jail inmate, accused of overpowering a guard and leading authorities on a manhunt last week. Well, amid heightened security, he made his first court appearance this morning on those charges. 29 new felony charges he's facing include kidnapping, false imprisonment, attempted murder, and many more. Also, another question comes to mind for many. What is being done to prevent a repeat escape and make sure a 120-pound female guard isn't assigned to guard a 6'7", 270-pound man? Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live tonight in Santa Cruz with the story.
Well, Dan, the sheriff's office is moving forward with new protocols on guarding inmates, while the district attorney is prosecuting 29 new charges against Ainsworth.
The 6'7", 270-pound Maurice Ainsworth was greeted by an army of cameras in a Santa Cruz County courtroom Wednesday morning. Both his hands and feet were shackled with steel restraints. He faces 29 new charges following last week's manhunt, including escape by force, battery on a peace officer, and attempted murder.
We just followed the path that Mr. Ainsworth decided to take that day. And when we were led down that path, at each stage of that path, there was different victims and different criminal acts that he did.
There are several crime scenes at Dominican Hospital where Deputy Kathy Bramante was attacked and where he fired off a gunshot at a receptionist. The parking lot outside the hospital where he fought with the deputy. At Secret Garden Preschool where Ainsworth held a gun to a teacher's head. And finally, this home on English Drive where he held two people captive.
He put many people in harm's way, and it's my responsibility and my job to make sure that never doesn't occur again.
Ainsworth is already facing life in prison for a Los Gatos home invasion robbery. His attorney is concerned that all the publicity in this case may prevent his client from receiving a fair trial.
I'm concerned that the media coverage will make it impossible for him to get a fair trial in a case where he has a where it doesn't appear that he's guilty.
Ainsworth's escape has the sheriff's office introducing new security procedures when transporting inmates to hospitals for treatment. They include two deputy sheriffs for all medical transports and the use of what are called soft restraints when the hard metal restraints are removed.
For example, in this instance, the suspect in this case was undergoing a procedure where metal could not be in the room. So the doctor and medical staff directed those shackles, the metal shackles, be removed. The use of plastic restraints allows us to still have the suspect fully contained in some sort of restraints, even during medical procedures.
Now, these are but a few of the security measures the sheriff's office is willing to discuss. There are more, but the department wants to keep those under wraps. Meanwhile, the department is still meeting with other agencies, including hospitals, to improve security measures. Dan?
All right. Thank you very much, Phil. More on Ainsworth, by the way. During today's hearing, the judge set bail at $2 million. So Ainsworth will come back to court next week to enter a plea and for further arraignment, again on these charges. As for the deputy who was assigned to guard him, she is Kathy Bramante. She is still recovering from her injuries and hopes to be back at work with the sheriff's department soon.